What's up, guys, and welcome back to MBGL7. We got game two between TNC and Execration on the way, as game one was, well, pretty brutal. TNC had Execration at every turn, especially early game, with an offensive tri-lane that probably shouldn't have worked as well as it did, but hey, doesn't matter. With a Viper, that probably shouldn't have done as well as he did, but if you're a TNC fan, you're pretty happy. If you're rooting for Execration, then yeah, hopefully for your sake and your Rare's sake, they can switch things up a little bit. I'm Mike Loris, going to be your caster for this second game. This is a best of five, so there's no elimination yet. Although, after the last game with Christian, definitely have to shake things up. I said at the tail end of the last game, Execration, you have to go for like a push strategy, bring out some cheese, a draw ranger, a niche pick, something along those lines. Anything less than that seems like it might not be enough. But TNC, just stick to what works, man. That laning phase for Teehee was absolutely brutal. Faceless Void pick from Sam H was probably good enough to warrant a first ban there. In fact, I would say the hero in general, especially after a display like that, there you go, is powerful enough to be banned out early, and it will be. But of course, for TNC, they still be able to first pick Ventral Spirit, most likely what they're going to be looking to do if it's still available to them. So they're going to have to, Execration, again, try to throw a little bit of a curveball while trying to be a little bit subtle. Lone Druid, Invoker, Death Prophet, I guess the last two were still in the pool for quite a long time. Yeah, but those powerhouse heroes, maybe grab a Batrider here for Execration, just some way of starting out the small-scale engagements. They really also need to have just, like, overwhelming lane power. Even after last game, you would think it would be enough, but it wasn't the case. Lone Druid is available, and if they have a hero player capable of doing it, I think they should. Or Nature's Prophet. Okay, that was first banned out too. That's fair enough. Kind of plays to the same strengths of Lone Druid. Maybe to a lesser degree in some things, as far as, you know, brute force power is concerned. A little more elusive, that Nature's Prophet. But hey, whatever works to get those towers down. If TNC don't grab it, then... Well, I mean, Raven has a freaking Nature's Prophet image on his thing. Like, that's his... That's this right here, so I'm pretty sure TNC can play the Lone Druid. Don't quote me on that, though, guys. Sam H is an Ember Spirit one also, so there's that. I don't think they're going to take an Ember Spirit super high, although it is pretty good versus the Nature's Prophet. In fact, very good versus the Nature's Prophet, so maybe down the line. But right now, something like Ventral Spirit, a nice little start versus the Nature's Prophet. Maybe Ventral Spirit Batrider or something like that. Or maybe just Lone Druid of their own. There's quite a lot of selection here for the TNC side. Enchantress was previously banned out as well, and it seems like that is also a possibility, although not really going to be up in the first pick realm of possibilities. Ventral Spirit for Winter once again, and a Gyrocopter this time for TNC. Sure, why not? I mean, Gyrocopter is, you know, usually going to be one of those very non-objectionable heroes. Up against Nature's Prophet, the AoE, certainly going to be very useful. But this seems like, once again, TNC kind of gearing up to have just a really powerful 1-2 punch, maybe 1-2-3 punch in the lane. Maybe the off lane. Again, TNC maybe thinking about going for more of aggressive power here. Gyrocopter doesn't quite have as much level 1 damage through level 3 damage as the Juggernaut, but he can certainly get the job done. Execration can grab a Dazzle, try to keep themselves safe from it. Probably one of the better heroes to have as far as, you know, trying to keep yourself alive. Not really at returning fire. So if TNC really want to go for an offensive tri-lane situation, they can do it. You know, just grab like a Visage or something, and then you'll be blasting heroes down left and right. But of course, the threat of doing that for TNC is that should they decide to go for that, they'll sometimes have a situation where they'll be on the aggressive, they'll get a couple kills, but then there will also be situations where Nature's Prophet is going to teleport in. And 4v3 in the early game stages, yeah, there's no really not much of a way to counteract that being the side with 3. So TNC, it looks like they're just going to ban all the heroes that can resist that. Juggernaut, maybe a Slark even, if they're really scared of that. I don't really think they should be, but you know, heroes that can resist this Magic Missile into Rocket Barrage combo. In the meantime, Broodmother and Enchantress both can be banned out. Lone Druid is still available for either side. Execration may need to, you know, make a couple of respect picks towards this TNC brewing aggressive tri-lane. But at the same time, they have Nature's Prophet, they have Dazzles, they have Push, Power, and Sustain. They get a little bit more into either department. I was going to say with Lone Druid, then they'll be golden. But, okay, TNC. safe lane Drow Ranger with Vengeful Spirit with a Gyrocopter mid? Is that what's going on here? Is there a TNC mid? Or a fucking Teehee mid. Yeah, there's going to be a TNC mid, I'm pretty sure, guys. Jeez. It's still early. Cut me a break. But this is a rather early pickup of Drow Ranger. Execration's opener of Dazzle Nature's Prophet isn't exactly the best at handling a Drow. In fact, they're both pretty bad at it. So they will need to maybe go ahead and get that Slark. A Phantom Assassin, anyone who can just get into the face of Drow Ranger. TNC, though, they have the nice little Venge Drow combo. So, again, a little nice 1-2 punch there. Visage is a possibility that Execration will probably not be super willing to grab themselves. Visage Dazzle is really awkward as a support duo. So if TNC want to grab that, they'll have that as well. And then, you know, offensive power is going to be through the roof for TNC. They will maybe be lacking in the survivability department. A hero like Dazzle is really good with Drow Ranger. Of course, you know, being ranged is one thing, but that sustain, that ability to keep Drow Ranger alive after she gets jumped is invaluable. And this is really smart for TNC by first picking the Vengeful Spirit. They've protected their Drow Ranger up against the Batrider, at least as much as they can. They will have the swap power, you know, to defend the Drow down the line as well, but it's not as definitive. And the Execration are going to not go for the in-her-face route. They're just going to blow her up. Zeus is a start. Not going to do the job all the time, especially if he gets gusted or magic missile or something. But TNC, they have so much, you know, just brute force tower pushing strength right now. If they want to go for another Viper, it doesn't seem like that's going to be the worst situation here. A Viper very traditionally picked up with Drow Ranger comps just to get some sort of frontline. And it will not be the worst to just throw towards mid. Queen of Pain, though, man. Okay, TNC are going to be going a little bit fragile. Maybe a little bit more fragile than I would personally like, but maybe I'm a coward. Who knows? I don't know, guys. Yeah, Queen of Pain is looking to have a decent time in this game because, again, there's not many ways of Execration to control the Queen of Pain. As far as heroes that could just annihilate her in the blink of an eye, Zeus cannot really do that. Lycan cannot really do that either. So Lycan is, you know, okay, I guess, at chasing down a Queen of Pain after she blinks out in certain situations. This is mostly a pick towards that Drow Ranger, though. This is Lycan with Nature's Prophet as well, so Execration will have that very balanced and fair combination as far as pushing towers of their own is concerned. I'm not sure, even with that combo, that it's going to be powerful enough to race TNC for tower damage. Like, you pretty much cannot beat a Drow Ranger in a 1v1 basis, in a 5v5 basis when you're racing for towers. I don't think that's actually possible, assuming even amounts of farm. But Execration, they have quite a lot of early game push power right now. Maybe they'll try to get in under this Drow Ranger, although that usually doesn't really work too great. They're going to ban out the Disruptor themselves, try to protect their Lycan and their Zeus a little bit. And I guess the Nature Prophet as well would have been an ace hero for a TNC. Shadow Shaman in the meantime, the pushing hero, the pushing support hero being banned out by the TNC side. But if you're looking to kill heroes, I think like controlling this Lycan for TNC is pretty much out the window. They have Magic Missile, but they're just going to just try to straight up kill him. Like, you could run away, maybe, but I still don't think that the Visage is a terrible selection here. Although, a little bit of AoE for TNC might be decent. Alina as their last pick. A ranged hero, yeah, maybe a little bit soft, but we'll have crowd clearing. Maybe able to contest that Nature's Prophet Lycan. I don't think they're going to be doing anything weird with, like, Gyrocopter support or anything like that. There's a possibility. TNC could also look for a little bit more bulk out of their last pick. I don't know, like, an Undying or something like that. A Sand King. You know, one of those slightly tankier heroes to get into the front line, be a little bit disruptive. A supporting Spirit Breaker, even. That doesn't seem the worst for TNC. Earthshaker, I mean, they definitely do have melee options. And so being able to, even though you're melee, you don't necessarily get the damage benefit of the Drow Ranger. Get the tankiness, usually. Get the added benefit of maybe having a couple more heroes with AoE, as ranged heroes with AoE, or, you know, they are there. But they're super glass cannon, Lina being the big one. So it's just a question of how much do TNC actually respect this Like and Nature's Prophet push power? They should quite a bit, but at the same time, you don't really want to sacrifice your own team's strength to try to deal with the enemy, what the enemies are doing. You want to be the one who's assertive, and Tidehunter is going to be that hero. As melee as he may be, this is... Ooh, is this actually going to be... I'm trying to think. TNC very frequently run weird stuff. I don't think I've seen them run a support Queen of Pain. I don't think I've seen them run a support Gyrocopter. They might have run a support Gyrocopter before, but if not, I mean, usually Tidehunter is going to go towards that offlane. It may just be a supporting Tide with Eventual Spirit. Line is the last pick for Execration, a much-needed disable in order to, you know, first of all, shut down the damage output of the Gyroranger Gyrocopter, but also just lock down in order to kill off the Queen of Pain later on. Pretty easy pick there for Execration. Doesn't offer a hell of a lot in the push department, but at a certain point, there's just no supports that do. Chen Enchantress were out, Shadow Shaman was out. Yeah, there's not much that they could grab to push. They're just going to go the disable route instead, which is not terrible. But it seems like, well, Queen of Pain, AU. That is interesting. Yeah, I mean, I was going to say Tidehunter Eventual Spirit is like one of your old school support combos, like freaking 2008 support combos. Good times, but it's kind of fallen out of favor, and I think everyone knows why. I mean, we know how good Tidehunter is in the offlane now. I think that was a Kraken Shell change that did it, and the Anchor Smash change way back when. But TNC are going to run things... Oh, no. Okay, we don't know what they're doing yet, so we're going to let all of these teams swap up their heroes and whatever before we really get into it. But for the most part, Execration... A lot of this game revolves around this Lycan and the Zeus. Usually it's going to be in the supports to try to buy themselves some space in the early stages, but they really just have to, at a premium, put their own lives at risk to try to kill off this Gyroranger, or at least cancel off her agility bonus. The agility bonus of the Gyrocopter is just obnoxious. The Queen of Pain gets really dangerous as well. So Execration, they will have damage and then some. TNC will have damage and then some. Execration just... have to make sure that they get on top of them in lane. Again, try to take them out early on. And I'm not really sure how possible that is because TNC are working with so much damage. This Tidehunter set, by the way, all the spikes and shit, looking pretty sick. One Wolf is going to get absolutely demolished by the entirety of TNC. That dog did not stand a chance. You guys have to pay your respects to the dog. But yeah, this is game one. TNC currently with a game... Oh no, not the other dog too. Say it ain't so. TNC with a one game lead, let's see if they can make it a 2-0, and it looks like they have settled on their heroes. We've got Winter G Small Sun as the Eventual Spirit. Raven is going to be playing the Drowranger. AU is playing the Tidehunter. Boots first, looks like he's going to be playing an interesting role this game. Teehee is on the Gyrocopter. We got Sam H on the Queen of Pain. On the other side, we got Shanks, who's going to be playing the Zeus. He's over towards the mid lane, RR. Boots first on the line with Earthspike level 1. Playing the line, I'll talk about that in a little bit. Lumic is on the Dazzle support, down towards bottom lane. Nando's going to be farming it up as the Lycan. Got BYB up on the top lane as the Nature's Prophet. Pretty interesting opening here for RR. Boots first on Lion is decent if you have someone else who's really good at roaming with you. An Eventual Spirit, Alina, hell, a Crystal Maiden, a Sven, anyone who's really good at roaming. A Spirit Breaker if you want to list good heroes at it. But yeah, Lion, by himself, with Boots first and Impale, is kind of mediocre. Like, Earthspike, sorry. It's called Earthspike, not Impale. With Earthspike. Because if you look at Earthspike, it doesn't actually do a lot of damage until later on. The stun duration, 1.1 seconds, is very, very low. And who's really going to help you get those kills when you gank in? A Zeus, he has a lot of damage, but you know you need a lot of to actually kill them off. Of Nature's Prophet isn't really going to do that much either. Unlike what we saw in the last game, where the Eventual Spirit was able to gank any given lane because she was ganking lanes with a Viper chilling in that lane or a Juggernaut, the Lion will not have that same luxury. So he will have to do a lot of heavy lifting if he's going to have any chance at actually getting those roaming kills. It's going to be, to say the least, very difficult. This is going to be interesting mid lane, though. Teehee has gone for regeneration up the wazoo. He should versus a Zeus, but also has grabbed Magic Wand before anything else. His supporting duo of Tidehunter Ventral Spirit is very dangerous. It is not to be underestimated. Even though Tidehunter support is, you know, a lot of people will scoff at that. With the Gush and Magic Missile and just Beatdown, there's so much kill power there. Especially if you're ganking a lane with a Queen of Pain, or a Gyrocopter, or a Gyranger, and you have that extra base damage on all your heroes. It's a threat that Execration will have to answer, and maybe the Lion will roam around, you know, kind of defensively in order to anticipate that. But Tihi, as I said before, has the magic wand. How the hell did he... Okay, I don't know how he didn't get the first charge out of that, but he has the magic wand, so a lot of generation for this Gyrocopter. Curious to see how much homing missile he's going to get, if any at all. The Zeus is very susceptible to that. Just being super immobile, being up against Eventual Spirit and a Tidehunter support duo. If they just throw a missile on him, if it connects, then Zeus may just straight up die. But, you know, Tihi so far is going to go for pretty vanilla Gyrocopter build. Take a quick look at this top lane, it's going to be super boring, shouldn't really touch on that too much. Raven's just going to be power farming it up. Nature's Prophet cannot do that much against her. If he gets too close, it's going to be frost arrows in his face, a hell of a lot of them. And there's not really that much he can do about that. He can jungle though, and that's what Nature's Prophet does if you're playing a pub game. We all know it. This Tidehunter though, he's stacked up the Ancients once, he has yet to get anything. He sees Shanks. If they set up a homing missile here, see, this would be a pretty big opportunity, at least in theory, to put some damage on the Zeus. But again, Gyrocopter only with 1 point spent so far. One skill point spent so far. Definitely holding on to his options for a little bit later. Has the boots now, though, so closing in for the Rocket Barrage, a lot easier. And Shanks has to be very careful. He does not know where this Tidehunter is. Has not seen him the entire game. AU is going to stay hidden. Oh, right in vision, though. So he's going to start charging the Zeus. Probably not a great idea. Bottom lane is a little bit more of an interesting lane. Sam H has the Blink and the Shadow Strike now up, so he can trade hits okay with Nando. The only problem is that he's up against a Lion who's level 2. Blink out before the Hex can come in and keep the Queen of Pain from taking any damage whatsoever. And that's the power of an offlane Queen of Pain. If you don't disable her, she will just straight up leave every single time. But at the same time, the Lion with an Impale, Boots first, and Hex is pretty much as anti-Queen of Pain as it comes. Again, I'm not really sure if this is worth the early boot purchase, but it's only 400 gold. Not too bad at all. Sam H has another blink, and he shouldn't get caught by that. He'll even dodge the right click, because that seems fair. Now, Nando's going to be farming in this bottom lane very happily. He's got the Ring of Basilius already, so the mana regeneration for the Wolves is up and running. He's got the Quelling Blade, so he has base damage enough to kill off every single CS without missing it even close. Nando's going to be pretty happy, but at the same time, Gyranger is ecstatic up on this top lane. She's going to get the base damage for mostly Tihi. Queen of Pain can't really work it into her playstyle too much. Maybe trading hits with RR, there's a significant possibility in that, but if you get too close to the Lion, then suddenly you're just dead. Sam H is going to have to play a very delicate game. And so far, Tidehunter, only level 2 right now, is going to be on the pulling duty up on top lane, actually. Now, of course, I think it's only a matter of time for either one of these heroes. Oh, make an appearance. Oh, Sam H, he's going to hit with the Sprout. He has Tangos, he has Stick Charges, but it's not enough. BYOB's going to grab First Blood. Teleportation in, and again, Queen of Pain. You get hit with that Hex Impale, you are just straight up dead. Almost made an escape, but you know, that's what Nature's Prophet does, man. Comes in and secures your kill. BYB is going to chalk one up, and should be Howl on Nando. I mean, there will be. Maybe put a lot of damage in this tower as well. Of course, this is top lane, devoid of heroes, Raven and Winter, you can see, starting to shove it real hard. Now, this early on, they will win damage trades, as far as tower racing is concerned. TNC are just not ready to defend this yet, so this should be a free tower here for the Execration side. With First Blood on top of that, not too bad at all. The Queen of Pain, though, is going to get quite a bit of experience, and should not die unless Lion does something very sneaky, and he's going to teleport up towards top lane, so there is going to be no sneaky play here. Fortification though, Sam H, level 4, definite possibility here. Top lane though, taking a lot of damage itself. I mean, this is just two heroes up on top lane. We can already see how effectively Gyranger is starting to trade hits with the enemy team. I'm kind of disappointed that TNC have not, you know, just straight up roamed this Tidehunter Venge combo. But of course, you know, getting their levels up, I can't really blame them for that. That's definitely the right decision. I'm just personally a little bit bummed. But now Gyrocopter is level 6, so Gush into cooldown with Magic Missile, or homing missile. It's magic, guys, okay? Jeez, it's magical enough. The kill power is here on Zeus, and there is zoning him out of the lane somewhat. But again, Arc Lightning it's pretty difficult to miss last hits with Arc Lightning. And you can do it from a very safe range, so, you know, just what the Zeus does. Now, in the meantime, AU and Winter, they're getting a lot done in their own jungle, giving a lot of support to the Drowranger, and thereby denying a lot of top lane experience and farm to the Execration side. Holy lag, Batman. Not sure what's going on with my connection. Hopefully it doesn't drop. Yeah, they're restricting this top lane as much as they can. We can see that not really happening, even though Queen of Pain's tower did go down. She is still comfortable enough to stay in this bottom lane. Get a little bit of CS. Maybe not all the time, though. Has to be careful. As long as she sees the lion, and she does, she will be fine. Teehee is going to get jumped. He has stick charges and a regen rune, though. So this guy is not easy to kill. Nature's Prophet is just faking him out. Oh, he's actually going to commit this time, actually. Teehee's going to turn on everything. Here's the regen rune. Here's the call down. Here's the rocket barrage being split by the treants. However, here comes the backup. AU is the first one to arrive. Thunder God's Wrath is going to be popped up, but the Queen of Pain is actually assassinated Zeus beforehand. BYB is going to try to teleport out. I don't know what's happening. He's dead. Okay, that's what happened. Sorry for the connection issues, guys. I guess Southeast Asia. And Lion also gets caught in the mix there. And Nature's Prophet teleporting into his own doom. That was incredibly bold, to say the least. Again, you're going into a gyrocopter. We've seen time and time again teams underestimating the power of the gyrocopter. They walk in, they just get put into a blender. This is a gyrocopter with phase boots, max out rocket barrage, and the extra bonus damage from Gyroranger. Plus 17 without her ultimate even being up. And she also took down the tower in the meantime. So that was inherently a very risky play there from Execration. The fact that Tidehunter was there, I mean, one hero would have been there at the very least. Nanda, oof, dropping super low. Shadow Strike will cancel the south. Sam H has no blink just yet. He wasn't bottling up either. Now has to deal with BRB. Jump in from Nature's Prophet. Blink down to the south from Sam H. Chugging that bottle. Sprout not going to give him vision. Sam H has to wait a couple more seconds. Dig, Sam H. Dig. Lumic has one more tango. I don't think that's good enough. There's no Nature's Call. They don't see her. Sam H has another blink down. Oh, no, the Sprout does see her, but she's going to blink so far in. This is interesting. He's tangoing up. I think she's fine. I think Queen of Pain will not die here. They just can't get to her. She's gonna blink right back in. Nas gets spotted by the dog. And Sam H will have to eventually buy a TP and get out of there. But hey, mission success, I guess you can say that. 3-1 TNC starting things off pretty darn well. Drowranger now kicking into gear with her ultimate up. Level 6 double Wraithband with an Agi Power Treads. So, you know, very fair and balanced. Plus 30 to everyone, bar the Tidehunter, of course. He's actually not too far away from his level 6. Stack of the Ancients, only a double right now. But once that does get stacked up a little bit more, and it should be very shortly, unless these dogs get in the way, it seems like they will do just that. Oh, wow, that efficiency. That never occurred to me that you could do that. Unfortunately, this is going to miss. That's also going to miss. So, in theory, it would have been efficiency. But, you're not going to happen this time. Once the stacks come up, Tidehunter can clear it out by himself. Raven clear it out by himself, even. It's slower with the Gyroranger, but you can get a Gyrocopter on there very easily. You can do that. BYB also needs to watch out because there's an invis plane here. Here comes the missiles. One homing. Couple more from the sky with the rocket barrage there as well. BYB will get out of the call down area. He will still get hit with the plink, and he will actually survive. Nando is going to come in. Not shapeshifted, though. Not that much commitment here from TNC. They are going to have Putihi, though, right into the clutches of Shanks. Bolt is going to miss? He missed the Bolt? Are you kidding me? Okay, he's going to get beaten down by Centaur, so he pissed off with his passive. Nando, he's going to get Sonic Wave in the meantime. RR is going to miss the Impale on Sandwich. He jumps right over it, grabs a double kill. I chose the wrong fight to watch, guys. Jeez. Sam H coming in like a freaking superhero. And ooh, Gyrocopter actually does pick up the Zeus. Okay, well, yeah. Shut up, guys. It's still 8 a.m. I only got like 3 hours of sleep last night because I couldn't fall asleep. It's not my fault I'm missing these kills, okay? Jeez. We might not be done up on the top lane, actually. Man, this is just so much damage coming out from the TNC side. And the scary thing is that they don't even have Ravage yet. That's when their draft really gets scary. Oh, TP coming. You better cancel that. Oh, no. He doesn't cancel it. Swap back into the second missile. And Pale's going to hit onto Winter, but T somehow dodges it. Another spurt of lag there, but Lion, yeah, shouldn't have been teleporting in. TP coming in. This time it's Zeus. Winter doesn't have a swap. He only has one magic missile. They're not too healthy. They'll back off. Bottom lane in the meantime, minor amounts of split push here from Nature's Prophet, but it's not really anything to write home about. Raven's going to farm that one up pretty quickly. She has Helm of the Dominator. Ability to stack for herself is real. Of course, you get a lot of lifesteal, and the armor is actually pretty darn good for Sex Creation in this game. Oh, Winter, is he just dead? Thunder God's Wrath? Oh, he doesn't have it. No, now he has it. Kaboom! Kaboom, I said. What the hell is this lag, guys? We will, you know, she's dead. We got her, but it was lag. It wasn't Zeus being stupid. It was Zeus lagging, or it was me lagging and couldn't see the Zeus. So yeah, again, my apologies. I'll try to restart Dota afterwards. But it's good enough. I'll keep it like this, unless you guys really want me to try to reconnect right now. Okay, it's getting really bad. That's not bad. Got all my packets. Packets are overrated anyway. Gyrocoptering and teleport up to this top lane. After having destroyed the bottom lane, TNC are working with a hell of a lot of momentum right now. Nando's going to shapeshift away, not taking any chances. You can see the Gyrocopter and Gyroranger, though. Their net worth is real. 6k apiece, whereas the next highest for Execration is Lycan. Okay, I'm going to have to restart, guys. I'm sorry about this. No. Actually, yeah, we're gonna have to restart. Close it all. Shut it down, boys. Well, I just realized this overlay have... Oh, you guys see my desktop. It's a good thing I didn't have anything loot on it, right? Alright, let's try this. Alright, I'm sure something is happening and it's amazing. If I come back in and everyone is like 3,000 gold richer because something happened, like, I'm just gonna lose it. Yeah, TNC doing pretty well. They may not have the number of execration as much this game, but did anyone die? 2-7? It doesn't seem like anyone died, although I might be wrong. TP's coming up towards top lane, perfect timing. Nando, he doesn't have shapeshift, and he's in a lot of trouble. This tower probably will die, but Nando has a homing missile following him. He has no TP, so he's in the corner. He will get hit with the missile. Gush is there, plus TP's damage output. In the meantime, they're going to catch up to Lumic. Swap back, cancel TP. They'll grab the kill there. Nando trying to hide in the trees. Will not happen. Two kills here for TNC. And that is going to be that. TNC are going to have also the Blink Dagger untied. Looks like I missed that when I was reconnecting. And, ooh, Roshan, okay. I missed that as well during the reconnect. Raven is unkillable now. They can kill him off once, but by the time she actually respawns, her allies are going to kick into full gear. And we can see the damage plus 45, plus 20%, whatever that is. This tower is just going to take a beating. And whoever's going to teleport in has to be careful. Because, well, I mean, there's no swap just yet, but there soon enough will be. Everything's going to bounce on through, though. AU does have the backup Ravage just in case. And TNC are rotating with their final hero. It's Teehee from the mid lane. This is going to be an aggressive wraparound. They're looking to fight this one. They're not interested in slow sieging this. They just want Nando, who's actually no AFK. Nando, what are you doing? We'll get graved up, but the Ravage comes in. He may be shapeshifted, though. The missile will still follow him. Winter has a swap back, and Nando is in a lot of trouble. Finger of Death will kill off the Gyrocopter, so RR is going to chalk that one up. It's a 2-for-1, though, and oh my god, they killed him by cutting off his head. Those monsters. That's going to be a big kill for the Lion. That's his Blink Dagger, but even though the Blink Dagger for initiating is nice, you actually have to have the brute force power afterwards to kill off those heroes after you initiate, and it doesn't seem like that's the case right now. TNC, yes, they do lose the Gyrocopter, but it is going to be worth it. Blink Dagger in from RR, impale onto Winter. Gustism, though, immediately, though, he'll turn around for a magic missile, gust, and wave through to Raven. Is going to grab the kill, get spiked up, doesn't have the Aegis, actually lost it before, and RR will survive. Blink Dagger already providing some huge benefits to the Lion, catching TNC off guard, and you unable to really help significantly there. But still 5-12 TNC. They do lose a couple heroes, namely that Gyroranger, worth a hell of a lot to the Execration side. They gain the entirety of the top lane. They take a pretty massive team fight up on top. And they still are working with a lot of momentum. Drums, Helm of the Dominator, Gyrocopter, probably looking for a BKB in the near future. Gyroranger, SNY actually is coming up on her. Maybe just Yasha, BKB, to Manta style. Bottom line, there are big items coming up from TNC. No Midas is this game, unfortunately. Unfortunately for the viewers, since, you know, everyone loves Midas gaming. But hey, it works, man, it works. Next creation, they have taken just two towers, just two tier ones. Pretty insignificant in the grand scheme of things. Again, this is a Lycan Nature's Prophet draft with Zeus as well. Their cores do not really scale fantastically, at least when you compare them to the Gyrocopter, Quap, and Drow of the TNC side. Execration, they have to be the ones winning right now. Their net worth and their cores isn't looking too terrible, but it's not looking that great compared to what TNC have. At least this tier 1 tower needs to fall. Like, they need to be actively pushing towers. Ninja Prophet has been doing his best, at least towards bottom lane. Try to chip that one down, at least. Maybe not chip it down, but, you know, force heroes to be on the bottom lane. Try to defend that. It only works so well, though. RR, he really wants to go for AU. He's got the wolves there. Jump in. Raven, however, is right around the corner. Gust onto 2. It's not going to catch Nando. And AU, well, he's not going to have a chance to blink either because of the wolves. Gets sprouted up. That's actually going to protect him versus the Lycan. That's going to mean that he lives. Now Sandage is going to jump right in towards BYB. Raven just needs to land one Frost Arrow, but Teehee's going to come in instead. Gust is going to be thrown, and the call down. BYB is going to sprout the entrance. Blink forward from Sandage is going to jump right over. In the meantime, they're in their main fight. AU's gushing a Nando, who's not going to get the Tidehunter. The Necrunits will also fail to do the job. There is no Thunder God's Wrath, nor is there Wrath of Nature. Tidehunter lives. And the Nature's Prophet and Lycan both fall. TNC, again, have Execration's number. They would have lost the Tidehunter with no exchange in any other given situation, but everyone from TNC, they were already coming in. They were anticipating that gank, and they have no ward vision on, well, like, this half of the map. So, like, they just knew that that was going to happen. Bait? Maybe. Insane plays? Maybe. Who knows? Bottom line is that AU is going to survive, and man, this Tidehunter is actually farming up a lot more than I thought he would for a support. For a support Tidehunter. Queen of Pain also, not with the most, you know, farm in the world for a Queen of Pain, but for an offlane Queen of Pain to have one O staff, not too bad at all. Orchid right around the corner. And you can get that on the Nature's Prophet or the Zeus. They're just shit out of luck. The Zeus is not doing too bad for his net worth. But I mean, even with the lens and the soon-to-be veil, it's like, yeah, you can do a lot of damage, not once the BKBs come up, and not if you're dead. And rest assured, Zeus dies super quickly, so TNC, they will have BKB on Raven very quickly. I assume Gyrocopter's going to be going for his own as well. Yeah, Zeus can only do so much here. And, of course, you know, got Tidehunter going for a pipe, so it's like, yeah, nice Thunder God's Wrath, bro. Does nothing. It'll do a little bit. Just not enough. And this is all in the context of Execration needing to be ahead. Their rat is pretty substantial, but you know, ratting only really works if the enemy team cannot outright push you. Sam H is gonna get jumped though. Impale, Finger of Death, Thunder God's Wrath. That's a super dead Queen of Pain. Jeez. I think she's dead, guys. I think she's dead. TNC take a casualty there. Much needed for Execration. Any kill is a good kill, but you know, Queen of Pain's net worth, again, is not really where it should be. So in any other given game, make a kill like that happen, and you're high-fiving and happy and everything. But in this game, it's like, you know, it's an offlaner. It doesn't even have that much in the way of net worth, so you don't really get that much for it. They're still happy about it, but man, they need to do a little better. They need to kill off this Drow Ranger a couple times. 1-1-4 with BKB now up. She is very difficult to kill off. You know, Teehee also, not a bad target to go for if you can. Not really sure about that if, though. Man, this lag. I don't know what's going on, guys. Game 1 was perfectly fine. Now in Game 2, everything's going to shit. It's a good thing we don't have any finesse plays in this game, right? Once the pipe comes up, though, TNC will be a little bit more willing to straight up go into the mid lane or the bottom lane. Again, the vast majority of the threat in this game comes from the Lion, Finger of Death, comes from the Zeus combos. If they answer that with survivability, i.e. pipe BKBs, or just offensive power, i.e. get the Orchid on him, then really you don't have much to worry about. Lycan only has a level 1 book and of lads. It's fine, I guess, but for 20 minutes in, you don't really have to be scared of that. Oh my lag, Batman. Sorry guys, it looks like there might be a fight soon, so I can't reconnect again. So yeah, you're just gonna have to deal with this. I mean, I'm gonna have to deal with this also. I don't enjoy watching this as much as you would think. I hate this just as much as you guys do. Alright, so we got BKB 1 up, BKB 2 pretty much up on Teehee. And Pipe, meh, a little bit farther away from AU, but it will be up soon enough. Tidehunter farms decently fast with the Anchor Smash, as long as he doesn't get jumped and killed. We've seen this scenario before, a couple heroes up on top lane, AU farming it up, and it looks like this time he's not going to get jumped, but And while these BKBs come up, the Orca is also being farmed, and Roshan just being, well, don't know when, but maybe eventually will respawn. Should hopefully respawn in this game. They're going to smoke up in the meantime. They have a wraparound of the Nature's Prophet. They don't know he's here, though. Now they do. They make a complete 360 and turn right around. Yes, I know. That doesn't turn you around, guys. It's a joke. Jeez, BYB is going to get jumped. He does have a teleport. The missile's coming in. They have so much damage. I thought they would be able to swap him out with the wave and to swap. Why swap him if he's dead, right? That's a dead Nature Prophet. However, yeah, he was going to get jumped. Blink, finger of death. Oh, Jesus. That is a super dead Tidehunter. That was a Tidehunter with Hood. And he just got, like, 100-0'd in less than a second. He's going to make a TP in. Unfortunately, not have enough to really do anything here. In fact, gets to watch out. Blink Impale is on him as well. BKB not going to hold. He's not even going to be able to get it off in time. And he will fall as well. RR is just overperforming once he gets this Blink Dagger all over the place. Blink Impale, Hex. Not much you can do about that. Even though you have the BKB, doesn't do much if you don't use it. Now the tower is going to be ground down to bits. The race is not on for TNC. They're not hitting any towers right now. In fact, Roshan's going to respond immediately afterwards. And the Tidehunter, well, he's dead, but he'll be back in order to fight that Rosh. But Gyrocopter probably won't be. Excretion, can they even take this tower and get Rosh? That's a lot, but man, they might have enough pushing power here. Don't underestimate the pushing power of a Lycan. TB coming in. And TNC, they are ready to go in theory. Raven just has to make sure not to get jumped, because that will be an absolute disaster. Yeah, they will hold the tier 2 tower now. TNC will also have enough time to respawn their gyrocopter and get into that Rosh pit. But Execration, this lion, man, Blink Impale, doing so much work, and it's not even going to get that much better should Tidehunter grab a pipe. Like, that Veil into Finger of Death? Jeez, I don't know the math on that, but it's probably a lot of damage when you have a Zeus there as well. I mean, Veil pretty much makes all your stuff pure. So yeah, it's a lot of damage. Maybe not pure with the Hood of Defiance also. I have no idea. I'm not even going to try to pretend to know what the math looks like. But in the meantime, TNC will grab that double life. They have a lot of... Oh wait, I thought that was Aegis for some reason. There's just a Wraith Band. Who cares? Aegis has an icon on the ground. Yeah. Nothing of value was lost. Raven still has a double damage rune. And TNC might want to just brute force now. In the meantime, Execration will start split pushing up towards the top. We have a ping out from Purple to do just that up towards top lane. But again, even though Execration do push incredibly quickly, I'm not sure if they push faster than TNC. They definitely don't push faster than the Drow Ranger with double damage rune. Radiant's Courier does get sniped. That is not the right courier. Wrong button. Didn't buy anything, so not the worst. But the race is on. Top lane with Howl versus mid lane with Drow Ranger. And mid lane Drow Ranger wins. Again, it's not even really close. And for Execration, they will get one tower, but they cannot go up high ground like TNC can. At least not yet, because they're not messing around here. This is a double life Drow Ranger that we're talking here. There is no creep wave just yet. In fact, it gets pulled off and annihilated. Weave is up. And Blink forward, Impale, Sam H, 100-0. Ravage is there, plus the cooldown. They're onto Shanks right now. A lot of damage. Gonna go down twos. Once Lion and Shanks both fall, and I don't see Shanks getting out of this. He's maimed and slowed down by the Frost. Top lane, though, is being pushed by Nando. Ranged Raxus and tier 3 claim. T is gonna make his arrival in. The Raxus, in the meantime, over in mid lane, though, Ranged Raxus dropped there as well. Blink forward, Hex, though, Impale onto Winter, and the Ventral Spirit's gonna get left for dead. Sam H cannot finish off that Lycan, and over in the base, the Wolves are going to work. It looks like it's not gonna do enough damage. Sam H should hold that, albeit barely. They don't lose Teehee. They don't lose the Tidehunter either. With the pipe, he will stay alive. It's a Rax for Rax trade, ranged for ranged. Not really huge in the grand scheme of things for either side, but that was a pretty clutch defense there from RR and Shanks. Again, the burst power is real. Queen of Pain, even though she has the Orchid, was even forced to buy back there. The buybacks were spent, a couple of them, in fact, Zeus, Queen of Pain, and Dazzle all spending that. But now if they pick off Sam H again, that's Queen of Pain off the table, and she will not see this one coming. You don't expect a smoke gank that fast after you take a fight like that. Looks like she will, for the most part, dodge it. Top lane, though, still going to get shoved in one more time. With no Ravage available, Tidehunter is going to be significantly weaker. As long as they keep the Drow Ranger alive, though, there is hope here for TNC to take a straight up 5v5. It looks like it's just going to be top lane defended. Again, Rax is taking a lot of damage here, but they'll all regenerate. Did this even take anything? No. Mid lane, perfectly healthy. For the Execration side, the Rax that Execration took, slightly more valuable than TNC's, albeit just. It's really not that much of a difference. But this really does help out the split pushers, more so than the TNC side. Oh, Sam H. Don't go in there. And blink out. Good idea not to go in there. Probably should leave, though, because there's a wolf behind you. He has another blink. BYB has the sprout, and Raven's actually going to arrive. Raven shouldn't be here. Lycan is still shapeshifted, although not really able to get close enough. He will burn out all of the Dragon Rangers, man. The backup's coming in. Teehee and AU coming from the top. RR has an impale for two. He's only going to land onto one, however, and with the damage to Teehee, got to bring down the lion. They see Nando. Do they have anything to interrupt it? Seems like Swap is way too far away. They'll pick off the lion, and that is has so far been the undoing of the TNC side, this lion play. But the question is that good enough to actually make a race here? Because top lane again is being pushed. Aegis Prophet, Lycan can join them pretty quickly. Oh no, Lycan's over in mid. Oh, this is not a good racing scenario. TNC, they have everyone alive right now. The Dry Ranger's going to get a full restore soon enough. Yes, they may lose the melee racks over in the top lane, but what they gain is complete racks on the bottom, I think. Pink is going to try to defend it. AU is doing his best, not really doing the best because it's a Tidehunter. Thunder God's Wrath is there with the Veil. Lots of damage, but swap back on Shanks. He'll blink out of there, and they'll lose the Vengeful Spirit. Sonic Wave will fly through. Sam H, though, is not too tanky. He'll die as well. And Raven, his Aegis, will be claimed. That's a Rax for Rax trade in total. Dry Ranger will pop back up alive. She has a BKB, so she shouldn't die here. And she will walk away. AU, in the meantime, will still hold the Raxes. So for TNC, yeah, they lose a couple of heroes. Make a relatively even hero trade, though. And it is going to be, Nando to shapeshift in. He wants to bum rush the Raxes. It's still fortifiable. AU's still here with the minus damage from the Anchor Smash. And we can see the Lycan is doing next to nothing here. Backup is coming in, however. And, oh, Tidehunter loses his Ravage mana. He will pop the pipe beforehand, though. Where's the backup? Where's Teehee? Where's the Drow Ranger? Nando needs to be dealt with. He's going to grab the Raxes. Will he die? Yes, he will. They barely got him, but in the end, now we have TNC with a one ranged Rax lead. Not anything to really write home about. This game is still up in the air, but so far we've seen TNC, yeah, getting bursted down pretty heavily. Like, that Veil into Thunder God's Wrath is no joke. But TNC, they still have a lot of gold. 5,500 on the Gyro Ranger, 33 in the Gyrocopter after the SNY, I think was his last item. He had like a Ogre Club after the BKB or something like that. But yeah, he's pretty darn wealthy, and Drow Ranger is going to get even more Frost. Kind of redundant for the Drow Ranger, but you know what? It gives her a lot of health. It gives her a lot of effective HP versus the Zeus and the Lion for the most part. Raven, oh, he's going to get veiled up. They see Shanks, though. Missile's coming in. And looks like he'll get himself to safety. Yeah, it's one of the few ways of actually getting raw health in the jar. Oh, blink in, RR, onto Raven, Finger of Death is there. She's not going to die just yet, though. Swap back out even after that BKB. That's a little bit of a mistake. They see RR, Lumic is going to also be caught as they picked off the line. Nature's Prophet also, in the middle of nowhere, gets picked off solo, actually, by Sam H. That's a 3-0. TNC don't lose anything. And the Lycan's nowhere close being able to split push. Raven's not too healthy right now, but... oh, they'll be able to take down the Raxes for sure. As long as Raven's alive, they have enough power to do this. Blink Ravage, nice one from AU, is almost going to hit a hero. But, man, does it matter, actually? Because Raven, he's going to slay the wolves. A couple of Necro units in the back lines. Raven takes some damage. They see Nando. He'll lose his shapeshift form, actually. Sam H is going to deploy Sonic Wave. Blink forward, scream. Nando is going to try to TP out. It looks like he'll survive, albeit just. Shanks is still doing what he can with the Arc Lightning, but the Rax have already been taken over in mid. 10 seconds left until the backup comes in. This is going to be a fight with no Ravage here from TNC. They have 10 seconds. That might just be good enough to actually win them the game, because they're looking at Megas right now. This Drow Ranger is doing so much damage. That's Mega Creeps, and now Execration, now they're ready to fight. Unfortunately, I think they might have just lost the game already, because even though they're really great at split pushing, once they're down Megas, there's no way they can do that. They have to beat through a tier 2 bottom lane. I mean, it's not that healthy, but still, the Raxes are very healthy here from TNC in the other lanes, in the non-top lane lanes. And as long as TNC are together, as long as they only look for the fight with Ravage, Execration need a Hail Mary right now. They need to just Doom Push or something. They need to hope that Lion gets a sick impale, the sickest impale slash Ravage of his life, with Zeus on top of that. There's a lot that has to go right here for Execration, a lot that has to go wrong. The best way for TNC to lose this game is if they buy a Divine Rapier, and they're not going to. They're just going to bulk up, and that is the correct decision. Buy health. Don't buy evasion. Evasion's stupid versus Execration. It doesn't do anything. Just get all the health you can. Satanic even for Drow Ranger. I would love to see that one. You may say, oh, it doesn't give her enough damage, and it probably doesn't in any normal game, but this isn't your normal game. You just need to survive. And if you do that, you're going to be golden. Speaking of, they're going to jump in, pick off Nando. At least try to. Raven's going to do a lot, but not quite enough. Impale and a finger of death. That's a little bit overcommitment there, but hey, dead's dead. Vengeful Spirit down. They save the Lycan. All lanes are being pushed out right now, but the Megas haven't even touched the base yet. Raven's actually going to pop a BKB charge, though, to kill off that melee Necro Warrior. A little bit aggressive there, but I think that's still fine. Oh, jump in. I've seen this before. BYB, Orchid, he's going to live this time. Same H has used the BKB of his own. Oh, wait, no, the Nature Prophet dies in base. Woohoo! I didn't think that that would be enough damage, but it was just enough. So Nature Prophet down, and even though he has the Aghanim Scepter, Wrath of Nature, pretty good at holding Megas, actually, as far as spells are concerned. And now the Megas are actually going to get to the base. We have a couple of random gyrocopters flying around here. Teehee is by himself because he doesn't give a damn. And X-Creation are going to start to lose their base because actually everyone from TNC is going to come in. Yeah, they can't really easily pick off the gyrocopter because he has so much raw health. And he has backup and then some. Jump in from Sam H, going to silence Shanks. They don't capitalize off of that, but he's silenced for however long, and that means he can't defend. That means GG. Jump in. Spike going to miss. Ravage. Not even going to be used. There we go. Ravage hits someone this time and, in fact, gets a kill as well. That's game two in the books. TNC pulling out the Dry Ranger to try to race X-Creation. And so far, my theory stands, you cannot ever race a Dry Ranger. Ever. Guys, it's going to be game two. And what could be the third and final game is going to be coming up soon. As TNC, they've just been all over X-Creation. I like the switch up for in playstyle for X-Creation. I do like the attempts. But unfortunately, it doesn't seem like this is going to be the game for them. This might not be their day, but they better get themselves together soon because they don't really have that many more attempts. Guys, I'm Mike Lowe. It's been a pleasure casting this series for you. It's been a pleasure casting MPGL for you guys. I'll be right back with what could be the last game of the day.